We are in now part 3 video. So far we have completed 7 problems in exercise 5.1. Isn't it? Part 1 and part 2 video, in that we have completed 7 problems. I hope you all completed your assignment and you all copied your classwork also. Isn't it? Now in today's part 3 video, we are going to start with 8th question. See the 8th question. Let P 11.7, Q 13.5.4 and R 9.5.4 be the midpoints of the sides AB, BC and AC respectively of triangle ABC. First up to this I'll explain. AB, in the side of AB we are having the midpoint P, they were saying. In the side of BC we are having the midpoint Q. Similarly, in the side of AC we are having the midpoint R, they are given in the question. Of a triangle ABC. First you are going to draw one triangle and you are going to keep midpoint in the AB side, BC side and CA side. Clear? You keep the dot and you write P, Q, R vertices. Find the coordinates of the vertices A, B, C. They have not given the vertices of A, B and C. We have to find the vertices of A, B and C. Yes, find the area of triangle ABC and compare with the area of triangle PQR. Clear all of you? First we have to find the vertices ABC. Afterwards, using area of triangle formula, we are going to find the area of triangle ABC. After finding, you are going to find the area of triangle PQR. Then we are going to compare the bigger triangle with the inner triangle. That only they were asking in the question. So student, this 8th problem is very very lengthy problem. What I am going to do is, I am going to write page number. Okay, this is the first page number. What with the question and the diagram I will not erase. Okay, till the last line I will not erase the question and the diagram. What I am going to do is, I will erase from midpoint only. Okay. Now after I remain only, I will erase and erase and I will write. Clear? Now first we are going to find the A vertices, B vertices and C vertices. For that, what formula we are going to apply is midpoint formula. Why? Means they are said in the question, AB is the P is the midpoint of AB side. So using the midpoint formula we are going to find out. See, first we are going to take midpoint of AB is P. Clear? Similarly, you are going to take midpoint of BC is Q. Then similarly, midpoint of AC is R. Okay? All the three sides one by one we are going to take. First, I am going to take midpoint of AB is P. A vertices is what? X1, Y1. B vertices is what? X2, yeah, sorry, I have written X3. It is X2, Y2. I'll change now. It is X2, Y2. See students, I have changed here X2, Y2 and the P point is 11.7 by midpoint formula. What is the midpoint formula? X1 plus X2 by 2, comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2, comma MX, comma Y. Clear? Instead of X1 and Y1, we are having X1, same X1 and X2 itself. So again we are going to write X1, X2 because we don't have any X1 value, we don't have any X2 value. So X1 plus X2 by 2. Similarly for Y1 also we don't have value. So Y1 plus Y2 divided by 2. But midpoint is what here? P. So for P value what we are having? 11.7. Clear? The next step we are going to equate X and Y coordinates. So this is our X coordinate. Similarly in this side this is our X coordinate. This is our Y coordinate. Similarly this is our Y coordinate. So only I have written equating X and Y coordinates. See X1 plus X2 by 2 equal to this 11. This Y1 plus Y2 divided by 2 equal to 7. Then you multiply, cross multiply this 2. 11 in X1. Numerator part you write as such, x1 plus x2 equal to 11 into 2, y1 plus y2 equal to 7 into 2. x1 plus x2 equal to 11 2s are 22, y1 plus y2 equal to 7 2s are 14. Clear? Mark this as equation 1 and 2. Okay, now this is our equation 1 and 2. Clear all of you? This is our equation 1 and 2. Now we have used what side? AB side with midpoint P. Next, what side we are going to take? BC side with midpoint Q. After erasing this, I will explain the side BC side. Clear all of you? This is our page number 2. I have erased and I have written now. See, now so far we have found the AB side with the midpoint P. Now we are going to find BC side with the midpoint Q. We are going to find. See, midpoint of BC is Q. Clear? B value is what? B vertices is what? X2, Y2. C vertices is what? X3, Y3. Midpoint Q vertices is what? 13.5, 4. This we are going to do how we have did for the side AB, the same only we are going to continue everything. Clear? Midpoint of BC is Q. B x2, y2, C x3, y3, Q 30.5, 4. By using midpoint formula, we are going to solve this. Midpoint formula is what? X1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2 is equal to m of x, y. This we have seen in the part 1 video itself. Isn't it? Now, in, see their points. Instead of x, what are the values we are having there? X2, x3. Instead of y, what are the values we are having? Y2, y3. So, wherever you are having x, you just substitute x2, x3. Wherever you are having y, you just substitute y2, y3. Divided by 2, divided by 2. Midpoint is what for BC line, which is the midpoint? Q. So, Q is what? 13.5, 4. How we did for AB side? The same. Equating x and y coordinates we are equating. Which means this x part is equal to this x part. This y part is equal to this y part. So, x2 plus x3 by 2 is equal to 13.5. y2 plus y3 divided by 2 is equal to 4. Clear? How we did it? The AB side after this, we have cross multiplied. 2 into 13.5 we have did there also, you know. So, 2 into 4 is what? 8. So, y2 plus y3 equal to 8. Here, x2 plus x3, 13.5 into 2 is 27. Clear? In the AB side, we have got two equations that we have marked as equation 1 and 2. In BC side, we have got two equations. So, continuing the equation there, 1 and 2, no. Here, 3 and 4. Still, which side we are having? AC side we are having. For that, we will get 5 and 6. Clear all of you? Now, we will see the AC side. This is our page number 3. See, the last side we are going to find now. Midpoint of AC is R. A vertices is x1, y1, C vertices x3, y3, R is 9.5, 4. Now we are going to apply a midpoint formula. Midpoint of AC is R. What is our midpoint formula? X1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2 equal to m of x, y is our midpoint formula. Isn't it? Now if you see here, in the here what are x1, x3 we are having in the vertices. Similarly y1, y3. So in the place of x1, x1 itself we have to put. In the place of x2 we are having x3. So x1 plus x3 divided by 2, comma. Here what are the y value vertices you are having? Y1, y3. So y1 plus y3 divided by 2. Clear? The midpoint is R. R vertices what they have given? 9.5, 4. Okay, the same model only, equating x and y coordinates. So, with this x, I am going to equate with 9.5. With this y, I am going to equate with 4. So, x1 plus x3 divided by 2 equal to 9.5. y1 plus y3 divided by 2 is equal to 4. Now, x1 plus x3 equal to 9.5 into 2. If you multiply, we are getting x1 plus x3 equal to 19. Similarly, if you see this side, y1 plus y3 divided by 2 equal to 4. Cross multiply 2 into 4 is what? 8. So, y1 plus y3 equal to 8. Mark this as equation 6 and this as equation 5. So, students, we have found the side AB, BC and AC. Isn't it? So, totally we are having how many equation? We are having 6 equation. Now we are going to add these equation that you will see now. This is your page number 4. See, now totally so far we have seen 6 equation. Isn't it? We have derived 6 equation. Now among the 6 equation we are going to add 1, 3, 5. Okay, see there in red marker below I have written the equation 1, 3, 5. First we are going to add. Why I am taking only these equation means, first I am going to find x1 value, x2 value, x3 value. See these in these equation only we are getting x1, x2, x3, isn't it? So to find x1, x2, x3 value, I am going to add equation 1, 3 and 5. See, I have added. How we are going to add is, we are going to add all the LHS one side. See, x1 plus x2 plus x2 plus x3. x1 plus x2 plus x2 plus x3 plus x1 plus x3 is equal to 22 plus 27 plus 19. Okay, LHS separately we are going to add equal to RHS separately we are going to add. See, that only I have written. After writing this, x1 plus x1 is what? 2x1. x2 plus x2 is what? 2x2. x3 plus x3 is 2x3. If you have 22 plus 27 plus 19, we are getting 68. See, every way we are having 2. So, we are going to divide by 2 on both. Each term. Okay? Each term we are going to divide 2. So, now if you divide with 2, x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 68 divided by 2, if we are divide, we are getting 34. Now, you see here, x1 plus x2 value, what we are having here? In equation 1, x1 plus x2 is equal to, we are having 22, isn't it? So, in the place here, x1 plus x2, instead of that, we are substituting 22. See, in bracket, I have written equation 1. Here, because x1 plus x2 equal to 22, here x1 plus x2 we are having, in the place I am writing 22 plus x3 I am writing as such equal to 34. The next step, bring this 22 this side, it will become subtract. So 34 minus 22 is 12. Clear? Now one point, x3 point we have found, it is 12. Now with this we can find another value. What is that? Substitute x3 equal to 12 in equation 3. What is our equation 3? This is our equation 3. x2 plus x3 equal to 27. Isn't it? x2 plus x3 value is what? 12 equal to 27. The next step, you bring this 12 this side. 27 minus 12 is x2 equal to 15. Now we have got x3 value, x2 value. Still one more value we have to get. Isn't it? What is that? x1. So where x1 is coming? Either you can substitute in equation 1 or either you can substitute in equation 5. I have chosen equation 1. Substitute x2 equal to 15 in equation 1. Equation 1 is what? x1 plus x2 equal to 22. x1 plus x2 equal to 22. x1 plus, instead of x2 we are having 15 equal to 22. Take this 15 this side. 22 minus 15 is 7. Clear? Now we have got what? x1 value, x2 value and x3 value we have got. Next, what we have to get? y1 value, y2 value, y3 value. For that we are going to add remaining in between what equation we have left? 2, 4 and 6. Now we are going to add equation 2, 4 and 6 and then we will get the y1 value, y2 value, y3 value. Okay, we will see now that. This is our page number 5. Now we are going to add equation 2, equation 4 and equation 6. See, this is our equation 2, this is our equation 4 and this is our equation 6. Now if you see here, what in the left hand side separately we are going to add and this separately right hand side we are going to add. Now y1 plus y2 plus y2 plus y3 plus y1 plus y3 is equal to 14 plus 8 plus 8. Okay, that only I have written. Why we are adding equation 2, 4 and 6? To get y1, y2, y3 value. Clear? Now y1, 2y1, 2y2, 2y3. So 2y1, 2y2, 2y3 equal to 14 plus 8 plus 8 is 30. Everything we are going to, each term we are going to divide with 2. See, divide by 2 on each term. y1 plus y2 plus y3 equal to 15. So, we all know y1 plus y2 is what we are having, which is equal to 14 we are having, isn't it? We are having y1 plus y2 is equal to 14 value we are having, isn't it? So, in the place of y1 plus y2 we are going to put 14. This y3 equal to 15 we are going to write. Clear? Then next step, 14 if come this side, it will become 15 minus 14, isn't it? So 15 minus 14 is what? 1. So now y3 value we have got 1. Now next another value we have to find, isn't it? So substitute y3 equal to 1 in equation 4. Equation 4 is what? This is our equation 4. y2 plus y3 equal to 8. y2 value we don't know, right? y2, y3 value is 1 equal to 8. Take this 1 this side, y2 value we have got 7. Next, substitute y2 equal to 7 in equation 2. Into equation 2 I am going to substitute. y1 plus y2 equal to 14 is our equation 2. y1 plus y2 value we have got 7. Bring this 7 this side. Next, y1 value is equal to 7. Students, so for what we have seen, we have found the x1 value, y1 value, x2 value, y2 value and x3 value and y3 value. Everything we have found the, everything we have found of triangle ABC. Now we are going to find the area of triangle ABC. Clear? Now we will see the remaining. Now we are in page number 6. We have found the 3 vertices of a triangle, isn't it? Triangle ABC. X1 is 7, Y1 is 7, X2 is 15, Y2 is 7, X3 is 12, Y3 is 1 we have got. Now we are going to find the area of triangle, full triangle ABC. Okay, now we know all the X1, Y1, X2, Y2, X3, Y3. Now we can find easily how we did in exercise 5.1 first question. The same model. Okay, now I have told you many times, before writing, you have to plot the points in the graph. Then only it will be, you will get positive value. Otherwise, at last you will get area will be negative value. See how I am plotting now. Students, I have plotted the graph here. See, 7,7, it will come here, the first vertex. Then the 15,7 will come, 15,7 it will come here. Then C is 12,1. So I have told you, after plotting the graph, you have to come in anti-clockwise direction. See, in this direction only we have to come. So in this direction, this is our first point, 7,7. So if you come from this 7,7, next point is what? 12,1. See, I have written 7,7, 12,1. Then the next point is what? 15,7. Again, one more time, 7,7 you have to write. Clear? The remaining step, as usual, just we have to do the cross multiplication. See here, 7 into 1 is 7, 12 into 7 is 84, 15 into 7 is 105, minus opposite side, 12 into 7 is 84, 15 into 1 is 15, 7 sevens are 49. If you are adding this fully, we are getting 196, that adding means we are getting 148. So, if you subtract 196 minus 148, we are getting 48. So, 2 and 48, if you are cancelling, we have got the area equal to 24 square units. Clear? Now, the big area is what? Area of the triangle ABC is what? 24 square units. Next, which area we have to find? We have to find triangle PQR. Area we have to find. Area of triangle PQR we have to find. We will see that in page number 7. Students, now we are in page number 7. With this page, we are going to complete the 8th problem. Clear? So, totally we are having how many pages? 7 pages. You rewind and see the previous pages so that you will be very clear. Okay, now the last session we are going to do in this, we are going to find the area of a triangle PQR. We know in the question itself they have given P value, Q value and R vertices, everything they have given. So, you have to just find the area only. See, before finding, first we have to plot that vertices in the graph, I have told you, isn't it? See, 11,7. I have written very small, but you have to draw in your classwork neatly in the side of your note. 11,7, here it is coming. Okay, next 13.5,4, here it is, here this point is coming. Then next 9.5,4. I have told you, after plotting, you have to see in the anti-clockwise direction. See, you have to consider the first point. What is the first point? 11,7. 11,7. From the first point, what is the second point? 9.5,4. Then what is the third point? Third, what is it? 13.5,4. According to that only, you have to write this column. Clear? So that only you will get the positive area, otherwise you will get the negative area. Clear? 11, 7. Next vertices is what? 9.5, 4. Next is what? 13.5, 4. Again, one more time you have to write 11, 7. Clear? First, which side you will put the arrow mark? From right, from left to right. First red arrow mark only we have to see. Clear? 11 fours are 44. 9.5 into 4 is 38. 13.5 into 7 is 94.5. Minus. Now we are going to do it opposite direction, which is blue arrow mark. 9.5 into 7 is 66.5. Next one is 13.5 into 4 is 54. 11 into 4 is 44. This value, all the value we are adding means we are getting 176.5 we are getting. Similarly, if we are adding this side, we are getting 164.5 we are getting. The next step, in between we are having minus sign. So we have to subtract 176.5 minus 164.5. If we are subtracting, we are getting the answer as 12. So 2 and 12 will get cancelled, isn't it? It will go in 6th table. So after cancelling, we have got the area value as 6 square units. Clear? In the question, what they have told, find the area of triangle ABC and compare this with area of triangle PQR, they have told, isn't it? What is area of the triangle ABC we have got for value? Area of a triangle ABC we have got as 24 square units, isn't it? Now you see how many times this is smaller. So area of a triangle ABC is equal to 4 into area of a triangle PQR, which means what? Area of a triangle PQR is what? 6. So 4 into 6 is what? 64. Then you will get the area of a triangle ABC. We have compared now. Clear? With this, our 8th question is over. Clear? This is very, very big problem. If you are understanding the concept, means that thing is there in this problem. Clear? Next, we will see the next question. Next, we are going to see the 9th question. In the figure, the quadrilateral swimming pool shown is surrounded by a concrete patio. Find the area of the patio. See, they have given the diagram. See, inside we are having the swimming pool. Now, this is the concrete patio, which means walking area. Okay, consider like that. Okay, we want to find this concrete patio area we want to find. So, how will you find now? You have to first find the area of the quadrilateral ABCD. Then, you have to find the area of the quadrilateral EFGH. Then only if you subtract from the full part, if you take this part, means you will get the inside this portion, isn't it? The shaded portion we will get, isn't it? So from the whole, if you are taking this part alone, what we will get? We will get the shaded portion, no? So first we are going to find the area of the quadrilateral A, B, C, D. Next we are going to find the area of the quadrilateral E, F, G, H. Afterwards we are going to subtract the big quadrilateral with the small quadrilateral, then we will get the area of the patio we will get. Okay, see the in this page number 1, 9th problem, page number 1, I have found only area of quadrilateral A, B, C, D. In page number 2, we will find E, F, G, H. Clear? Now see the solution, area of your quadrilateral ABCD. I have told you, once if you got the vertices, immediately you have to plot in the graph, I have told you, isn't it? But in this question, they itself have given the diagram, they have given correct order. See, 6, 0 is what? Both are positive. Then afterwards, negative, positive, which means that is again quadrant. Negative, negative means third quadrant. Positive, negative means they have given in fourth quadrant. They have given correct order. So, no need to draw any graph again one more time. Clear? Similarly, E of GH also, they are like that only, they have given 3, 7, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant, the same order they have given. For this problem, you don't need to draw the quadrilateral in the graph. Okay, you straightly can start the problem. Now, see area of the quadrilateral formula I have written here, and we know the vertices A, B, C, D, isn't it? A is equal to, how will you write now? minus 4, minus 8, 8, minus 4, 6, 10, minus 10, 6, minus 4, minus 8, which means the first value have gained. One more time you are going to write. Listen students, area of the triangle and area of the quadrilateral are very very easy problem. Okay, only you have to remember is plus and minus only you have to give more concentration. Clear? The next step, first you have to come from left to right, red marker, red arrow mark you see. 4 4s are 16, 8 10s are 18, 6 6 are 36, 10 8s are 80. Minus 8 8s are 64, 8, 6 4s are 24, 10 10s are 100, 6 4s are 24. Now add those value, you will get 212. Similarly, if you are adding this side, we are getting minus 212. The next step, this minus minus will become plus. So 212 plus 212 is 424. That if you cancel with 2 means we are getting area equal to 212 square units. Here we have found the outer quadrilateral area. Now we are going to find the inner E of GH quadrilateral we are going to find out. Okay, now I am going to erase this. Afterwards I will write and put the area of the quadrilateral E of GH. Now this is page number 2 in 9th question. You see I have taken area of a quadrilateral E F G H. E vertices, F vertices, G vertices and H vertices, everything I have written. So we are going to write directly minus 3, minus 5, 6, minus 2, 3, 7, minus 6, minus 4. One more time the first value I am going to write again. Minus 3, minus 5. So arrow mark how will you put from left to right, isn't it? So minus 3 minus 2 is 6, 6 7s are 42, 3 4s are 12, 6 5s are 30. Now opposite side, 6 5s are 30 minus, 3 2s are 6 minus, 7 6 are 42 minus, 4 3s are 12 minus. So now if you add everything we are getting 90. Similarly if we are adding this we are getting minus 90. So in middle one minus we are having, that minus minus have become what? Plus. So 90 plus 90 is what? 180. So if we cancel 2 and 180 we are getting 90 square units. Clear? What we have to find in this question? Find the area of the patio they were asking. So how we have to find the area of the patio? Area of the patio is equal to area of a quadrilateral ABCD, full quadrilateral, minus area of the quadrilateral inner quadrilateral E of GH. For this quadrilateral, what answer we have got? ABCD, we have got 212. For area of a quadrilateral E of GH, we are getting 90. So if you are subtracting 212 minus 90, we are getting 122 square units. Therefore, you have to write the last line. Since I don't have space, you are going to write the last line. Therefore, the area of the patio is equal to 122 square units. Clear? With this, our 9th question is over and our part 3 is also over. Still, 2 more problems is there, 10 and 11 in exercise 5.1, that you are going to do as assignment for part 3 video. You are going to see now assignment. This is your part 3 assignment in exercise 5.1, 10th and 11th sum you are going to do as assignment. This 2 problem are very very easy problem. You are nothing but we are going to find only area of triangle. Area of triangle means what? 1 by 2, the given vertices you will write in the column and just you are going to do the cross multiply and simplify and going to write. Okay, you have to plot the points then only you have to write in the column. Okay, now first within the question, if you see a triangular shaped glass with vertices has to be painted. Okay, a triangular shaped glass we are going to paint. If one bucket of paint covers 6 square feet, how many bucket of paints will be required to paint the old glass? If only one coat of paint is applied. Now see here, what they were saying, we have to find here area of the triangle ABC with this given vertices. After finding, you will get the area equal to 60 square units. Okay, they were asking how many bucket we need to paint that triangle shaped glass. Okay, but to cover 6 square feet, okay, we have to paint 6 square feet. So that 60, that answer you are going to divide with 6. So that you will get the number of buckets. So now 10 is 10 number of buckets we need to paint the triangle. Clear? The glass shaped triangle. Now you see the 11th question. 11th question, nothing. They have straightly given the what to find. Find the area of the triangle with the given vertices. First, plot the values in the graph. Students, if you take off the page of your classwork, it's no need to take off the page. Less than off the page, you take and fairly neatly draw the graph. Okay, first plot, then you draw the anti-clockwise direction. According to that, you write in the column. Then you do cross multiplication. You will get the area of triangle AGF, and you will get similarly. You are going to do the second subdivision EGD, then third subdivision also BC EG. Clear, students? With this, our exercise 5.1 is completed. In next part 4 session, I will see you in the new exercise. Thank you, students.